কথা ভেবে, ছাত্রদের ভবিষ্যতের কথা ভেবে বাডওয়ান মডেল স্কুল শুরু করতে চলেছে অনলাইনে ই লার্নিং ক্লাস। এই অনলাইন ক্লাস শুরু হচ্ছে 14 এপ্রিল সকাল 9টা থেকে। প্রতিদিন সকাল 9টায় ক্লাস 10 থেকে 12 ছাত্রছাত্রীদের এই অনলাইন ক্লাস চলবে আনন্দবার্তা নিউজ চ্যানেল, আনন্দবার্তা ফেসবুক এবং আনন্দবার্তার ইউটিউব চ্যানেলে। তাই বাডওয়ান মডেল স্কুলের সকল ছাত্রছাত্রীকে 14 এপ্রিল সকাল 9টা থেকে এই অনলাইন ই লার্নিং ক্লাস অ্যাটেন্ড করার জন্য আবেদন জানানো হচ্ছে।
গুড মর্নিং এভরিওয়ান, স্পেশাল গুড মর্নিং টু অল দ্য স্টুডেন্টস অফ মাই ক্লাস 10। হোপ অল অফ ইউ আর ওয়েল, বাট আই নো ইউ আর ওয়েল ফিজিক্যালি বাট নট মেন্টালি, বিকজ ইউ আর নট এবল টু কাম ইউর স্কুল। সো ইউ আর ফিলিং বোর্ড, ইউ আর মিসিং ইউর স্কুল টু মাচ, বাট নাথিং টু ওয়ারি, উই উইল ওভারকাম দিস সিচুয়েশন ভেরি সুন। টুডে আই এম হেয়ার অ্যাট আনন্দবার্তা চ্যানেল টু কন্টিনিউ ইউর ক্লাসেস, ওকে? So as you know, my name is Rabonti Nandi and I am your biology teacher. So today we will start with the first chapter of your biology portion of your science book. So what is the name of the first chapter? That is life processes. So what is the name of the first chapter? That is life processes. So before starting the chapter, we have to know what does that term mean? What does that term mean, life processes? So before that, we have to know, we have to differentiate between living and non-living. How will you differentiate between living and non-living? So there are some processes which are occurring in the living body by which we can differentiate between living and non-living. Like that, first one is, as you know that we can move, but the boat can move? No. The fan can't move, the light can't move, but we humans and other animals can move. So movement is a property of living which can't be found in the non-living. So it is by this property we can differentiate between living and non-living. There are so many processes by which we can differentiate between living and non-living. So do all visible movements are required to understand who are living or not? No, because whenever we are sleeping, our life processes are going on inside our body and that time we are also living, okay? So the movement first, that term movement is first criteria of a life process. So what are the different life processes? What is life process? Life process is that the process of living to sustain or maintain all the body functions to be alive. So what does that term mean, living process? The process of living beings to sustain or maintain all the body functions to be alive. Okay, that means the processes that are required or that are essential to maintain all the body function for appropriate growth, for appropriate maintenance. Okay, so this is the meaning of life. Now we will know the different life processes. What are the different life processes? Look. Understand and the different life processes, you have to keep remember that tagline. What is that? That Mahatma Gandhi was reading NCERT book. You are also reading your NCERT book. So just remember that, by which you will be able to remember all the life processes. How? Look, M for movement. G for growth and development. Growth and so Mahatma Gandhi completed. Now that R, that M for movement, that G for growth and development, that R for reproduction. Now that NCERT book, N for nutrition, C for control and coordination, E for excretion, R for respiration, T for transportation, so these are the different life processes. I am repeating, Mahatma Gandhi was reading NCERT book. This is a tagline by which you can remember all the different life processes. Now what are the full forms? M for movement, G for growth and development, R for reproduction, N for nutrition, C for control and coordination, E for excretion, R for respiration, T for transportation. Okay, so these are the main life processes. I am repeating again, movement, growth and development, respiration and reproduction, nutrition, control and coordination, excretion and transportation. Okay, so we need to learn all the life processes one by one. Okay, today we will start with that process, that is nutrition. So today we will start that nutrition. Today we will start with that topic, nutrition. What that term mean, nutrition? Nutrition is process of obtaining food and convert it into simple form and utilization of that food by the organism for their proper growth and maintenance is called as nutrition. So I am repeating again, what is nutrition? The process of obtaining food by an organism and convert it into simple form and utilization of that for proper growth and maintenance is called nutrition. So I am repeating, the process of obtaining food by an organism and convert it into simple form, and utilization of that food for proper growth and maintenance is called nutrition. Okay, so this is the main definition of nutrition. Now we will know about the term nutrients. What does the term mean, nutrients? Nutrients means the materials which are present, or the elements or the substances which are present in our food that helps in our body growth and maintenance is called as nutrients. That means the main components of the food is called as nutrients. So next we will know about the different types of nutrition or different mode of nutrition. So now mode of nutrition. If we consider that mode of nutrition, there are mainly two types of nutrition. That is, first one is autotrophic mode of nutrition and second one is heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so first we have to know what does the term mean autotrophic and what does that term mean heterotrophic. Okay, so first, auto means self. Auto means self, and trophic, that term trophic is related to feeding or nutrition. So autotrophic mode of nutrition means there are those who can prepare their own food by themselves are called autotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so autotrophic nutrition can prepare their own food. Okay. And what does that term mean, hetero? Hetero means others. And tropic means, as you know, that is related to nutrition or feeding. So heterotrophic nutrition means organism which cannot produce their own food by themselves, which are dependent on others for their food, are called as heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So in case of autotrophic nutrition, we have written they can produce their own food. So in case of heterotrophic, we will write cannot produce their own food and dependent on others for food. Okay, so this is the main two types of autotrophic and heterotrophic nutrition. Now the autotrophic nutrition can be divided into another two. First one is photosynthetic, another one is chemosynthetic. So another subdivision of autotrophic mode of nutrition is, first one is photosynthetic and second one is chemosynthetic. Photosynthetic means organism which can prepare their own food in the presence of sunlight. Okay, how? By the process of photosynthesis. As you know that green plants can prepare their own food in the presence of sunlight with the help of chlorophyll are called as photosynthetic. Okay, so photosynthetic example plants. So can prepare food in the presence of sunlight. So can those who can prepare food in the presence of sunlight are called as photosynthetic. Okay, now come to the chemosynthetic. Those who can prepare food with the help of energy obtained from the inorganic substance are called as chemosynthetic. So we'll write can prepare food with the help of energy obtained from inorganic substances. They are called as chemosynthetic. CHEMO, chemo, SYNTHETIC, chemosynthetic. So organisms which can prepare food with the help of energy obtained from the inorganic substance are called as chemosynthetic. What are the examples of chemosynthetic? Nitrosomonas, sulfomolas, these are the some examples of chemosynthetic autotroph. Okay, so these are the main two subdivisions of autotrophic mode of nutrition. Next we will consider the main heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Consider heterotrophic mode of nutrition, we can differentiate into some groups. First one is saprophytic, SAPROPHYTIC. First one is saprophytic, second one is parasitic, PARASITIC. Parasitic, and third one is holozoic, HOLOZOIC. Okay, so these are the main three types of heterotrophic mode of nutrition. First one is saprophytic, second one is parasitic, and third one is holozoic. So who are called as saprophytic? Organisms which feed on dead organic remains like fallen leaves, excreta, they are called as saprophytic mode of nutrition. So what will be the example of saprophytic mode of nutrition? That is mainly fungi. Fungi are the under saprophytic mode of nutrition. So can I take this? Hello?
Hello ma'am,
board ta kichu dekha jacche na. Accha thik ache. So, saprophytic mode of nutrition. So, organisms which feed on dead organic remains like fallen leaves, excreta are called as saprophytic. I am writing in short, okay? So organisms which feed on dead organic remains like fallen leaves, excreta, etc. are called as saprophytic mode, having saprophytic mode of nutrition. Example, fungi. Next one is parasitic mode of nutrition. Organisms which take their food on the other organisms of different species okay, or organisms which are dependent on their for their food of the on the other organism of different species are called as parasitic mode of nutrition. Okay, parasites mainly live inside the host body and they take nutrition from the host body. And in case of parasitic mode of nutrition, we need to know two terms, that one is parasite and second one is host. Those who are giving that organism food and shelter are called as host, and those who are taking that food or using their shelter are called as parasite. I am repeating, parasitic mode of nutrition in which organism depend for the food or shelter on the other, for food and shelter on the others of the different species, organisms of different species. Okay, and two terms are important. First one is parasite and second one is host. Who are called as parasite? Who are taking the food or shelter from different organism are called as parasites, and who are providing this food and shelter are called as host. So just remember that two terms, parasite, host. Okay. So, parasitic mode of nutrition in which the example is tapeworm, lice. And in case of parasitic mode of nutrition, it can be differentiated into two, ectoparasite, endoparasite. In parasites can be differentiated into two, ectoparasites and endoparasites. Who are called as ectoparasites? Organisms which are living outside of the body of other organism are called as ectoparasite. Ecto means outside, and endoparasite, what does that term mean? Endo, endo means within. Endoparasites means organisms which are staying or living inside the body of another organism are called as endoparasite. Okay, so can you say me the example of ectoparasite? Yes, you know, that is ticks, mites, lice are the examples of ectoparasite. And can you tell me the examples of some endoparasite, like ascaris, tapeworm, roundworm? These are the some examples of endoparasites. Okay, so what is the difference between ectoparasites and endoparasites? Ectoparasites means, I am repeating, ectoparasites means organisms which are living outside of the body of the another organism, and endoparasites means organisms which are living inside the body of the another organism and taking their food. Okay, and I have told you the examples also. Next one is holozoic mode of nutrition. I am rubbing that part. So, if we consider holozoic mode of nutrition, we can say that organisms which are taking the solid complex particles as their food are called as holozoic mode of nutrition. That means holozoic, taking complex solid food. Okay, so those who are taking complex solid particles as their food are called as holozoic mode of nutrition. Okay, and holozoic mode of nutrition can be differentiated into some groups. First one is herbivores, second one is carnivores, third one is omnivores, and fourth one is detritivores. So first one is herbivore. Okay, so who are called as herbivore? Organisms which take only plant products or plants as their food are called as herbivore. Okay, I am repeating, organisms are taking plant or plant products as their food are called herbivores. So, who are taking plant or plant products? You know the example of herbivore, that is cow. What are the another examples? Cow, goat, buffaloes. These are the examples of herbivores. And next is carnivore. Who are called as carnivores? Organisms which are taking the other animal as their food are called as carnivores. That means carnivores are taking another animal as their food. So they are taking animals, other animals. Example, tiger, lion. There are so many examples of carnivores are also there. Next is omnivores. Omni means both. Organisms which eat both plant and animal in their food are called as omnivores. Organisms which eat both plant and animal in their food are called as omnivores. Okay, example, we, that means human. Okay, next part is detritivore. Who are called as detritivore? They are organisms which are taking dead animals as their food are called as detritivore. Taking dead animals since their food are called as detritivore. So what will be the example of detritivore? The scavengers are also under this group, that means vulture, okay, bacteria. So these will be the detritivore. Okay, so these are the main four types of holozoic mode of nutrition. So now can you say the difference between autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition? Now we will write the difference between autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition, and here we will write the main criteria or characters, and we will write the points here. So if we first consider the food, in case of autotrophic, what will we write? They can prepare their own food. But what will you write in case of heterotrophic mode of nutrition? They cannot prepare food by themselves. So first point is in according to the food, that means in case of autotrophic nutrition, they can prepare their own food, and in case of heterotrophic nutrition, they cannot prepare food by themselves. Okay, so this one is the first difference between autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Now second point. External energy. In case of autotrophic nutrition, an external energy is required in both. In case of autotrophic and in case of heterotrophic, autotrophic and chemoautotrophic, in both the cases that an external energy is required. So external energy is required in case of autotrophic nutrition, because in case of photoautotrophic, we have seen they are taking the sunlight to make their food. But in case of heterotrophic mode of nutrition, no external energy is required. Okay, so next point is digestion. Digestion is absent in case of autotrophic nutrition, but in case of heterotrophic nutrition, digestion is present. So, digestion is absent, but digestion is present. We have written three main difference. Next point will be example, autotrophic plant and heterotrophic human. Okay, now you can differentiate between autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition by these main points. Okay, so here you have heard about a term, what is digestion. So, you need to know what does that term mean. So, we will proceed for that one. In case of holozoic nutrition, there are some steps. Okay, I am writing the main steps. First one is ingestion. I-N-G-E-S-T-I-O-N, ingestion. Ingestion means intake of solid food by an organism. So, ingestion means intake of solid food by an organism. And after ingestion, what comes? That is digestion. Breakdown of complex food into simple form. Digestion means breaking down of that complex food, because in case of ingestion we are taking solid complex food, and digestion means breaking down of that complex food into its simple form. How? With the help of enzymes. Okay, we will read about the human alimentary canal here, where we will find that there are so many enzymes which are present inside our body and which are releasing whenever we are taking food, and they are acting on the food and breaking this complex food into simple one. Okay, so I am repeating again, what is digestion? Digestion means breaking down of complex food into simple one with the help of some enzymes. Okay. Next is absorption. Absorption means absorbing the simple food. Okay, in case of digestion, what we have done, that is that complex food has broken down into simple form, and in case of absorption, that simple food will be absorbed by our body is called as absorption. Next is assimilation. Assimilation means utilization of the food by different parts of the body. So what is assimilation? So food is absorbed inside our body, then we have to utilize that absorbed food by different body parts, okay? So that is called as assimilation. So I am repeating, assimilation is utilization of the food by different parts of the body. Next part is egestion. Egestion means elimination of the food, elimination of food from the body. Students, just write it down, it will help you later. So egestion means elimination, that means eliminate. We need to eliminate the food from the body by the process of egestion. So these are the main 5 steps of holozoic mode of nutrition. First one is ingestion, second one is digestion, third one is absorption, fourth one is assimilation, and fifth one is egestion. Ingestion means intake of food, digestion means breaking down of complex food into simple form, absorption means absorbing that simple form, and assimilation of food means utilization of the food by the body, and egestion means elimination of the food from the body. Okay, these are the main 5 steps of holozoic mode of nutrition. So we will find this type of holozoic mode of nutrition in both unicellular and multicellular organism. Okay, so we will see one examples in case of unicellular organism. So we will see in case of amoeba. So you can see that this is a diagram of an amoeba, and this one is a food particle. So this is the amoeba, and what is that? This is a food particle. So what is that? You know that amoeba can change its body shape. How? What is that part? These parts are called as pseudopodia. What does that term mean? Pseudo and podia. Pseudo means false and podia means feet. Pseudopodia means false feet. So amoeba can change their body structure with the help of pseudopodia. So what is that? That is pseudopodia, and this is the structure of amoeba. This is the nucleus, and this is a food particle near the amoeba. What amoeba will do? That will do that. They will first extend their pseudopodia will like that, and after that they will cover the food with the help of pseudopodia. Okay, so next, the food will be entered inside the body of the amoeba, and they will form a food vacuole. And after that, what will happen? Lysosomes will release some enzymes by which the food will be broken down, and the undigested food will be eliminated from the body. Okay, so next part is after digestion. Okay, so that is diagram of nutrition in amoeba. So I am repeating the different steps. If we consider the first step of holozoic mode of nutrition, that is ingestion, that is amoeba will intake the food with the help of pseudopodia or false feet, and that process of taking food is called as phagocytosis. What is that? Phagocytosis. Phagocytosis. As you know that amoeba can do endocytosis, it is having two types, phagocytosis and pinocytosis. Phagocytosis means intake of solid food particles, and if it is liquid then it is called as pinocytosis. So in that case amoeba is taking solid food particle, that's why their term is given that phagocytosis. So if we consider again the ingestion of amoeba, then the help of pseudopodia, amoeba will ingest the food by the process of phagocytosis. Next step is digestion. Lysosomes will secrete some enzymes in the food vacuole, and they will help to convert it into simple form. And next step is absorption. Amoeba will absorb that digested food, and that utilized by the body, that term is called as assimilation, and the undigested food will be eliminated from the body in the process of ingestion. So with the help of one example in case of amoeba, we can see the different steps of holozoic nutrition. Okay, so next day we will see the holozoic mode of nutrition in case of paramecia, and in case of human, we have to know the human alimentary canal and the total process of autotrophic mode of nutrition, that is photosynthesis. We will see that part also, and just read up to that portion, write it down, whatever I have written on the board, it will help you, and try to draw the diagrams also. Okay, and read that portion from your NCERT book. Okay, for today, up to that, thank you.
করোনার জেরে লকডাউন, আর এই লকডাউনের জেরে বন্ধ সমস্ত স্কুল কলেজ সহ শিক্ষা প্রতিষ্ঠান। ছাত্রদের কথা ভেবে, ছাত্রদের ভবিষ্যতের কথা ভেবে বাডওয়ান মডেল স্কুল শুরু করতে চলেছে অনলাইনে ই লার্নিং ক্লাস। এই অনলাইন ক্লাস শুরু হচ্ছে 14 এপ্রিল সকাল 9টা থেকে। প্রতিদিন সকাল 9টায় ক্লাস 10 থেকে 12 ছাত্রছাত্রীদের এই অনলাইন ক্লাস চলবে আনন্দবার্তা নিউজ চ্যানেল, আনন্দবার্তা ফেসবুক এবং আনন্দবার্তার ইউটিউব চ্যানেলে। তাই বাডওয়ান মডেল স্কুলের সকল ছাত্রছাত্রীকে 14 এপ্রিল সকাল 9টা থেকে এই অনলাইন ই লার্নিং ক্লাস অ্যাটেন্ড করার জন্য আবেদন।